As SAA Board Chairperson, and a preliminary legal opinion also casts doubt at the legality of Myeni's reappointment. Myeni's term expired last month, but it has since been extended by Finance Minister Malusi Gigaba until SAA's AGM in early November.
Dudu Myeni's leadership at the helm of the national carrier has been dogged by controversy. Her initial term was extended by 1 year when it ended last year. It's now been extended again until the AGM.
The normal practice is that the minister, although the minister is the identified person with the authority to appoint such boards or chairpersons of boards, normal practice is that it would go to cabinet for approval. But we hear from you that it did not go to cabinet for approval.
The deputy chair take over with immediate effect, and that the legality of it be dealt with in a way that will determine whether the meetings of the board chaired by Mr. Myeni since the 1st of September have any legal application.
Because if you insist that a person who is irregularly appointed or illegally appointed presides over SAA process, it will mean that the decisions that are going to be taken there are not legal decisions.
Myeni did not attend the meeting for health reasons, and Gigaba had other commitments. It was up to his deputy to provide an explanation.
I gave the reasons for extension, that there is a board evaluation, and the minister wanted to look at the board holistically. So I'm not going to go and find a reason anywhere else. That's the reason.
On the face of it, Parliament says Gigaba's decision is illegal.
Clause 13.5 of the MOI, in my reading, does not give the authority for the extension. Okay, that's all I'm saying on that.
Meanwhile, Utelezi has rejected suggestions this was a political decision, saying it's a business decision.
What complicates the matter worse is that credit lenders to SAA have expressed concern at Dudu Myeni's leadership and are reluctant to extend loan facilities to the airline. The struggling national carrier has loan facilities to the tune of 7 billion rand that are maturing soon and need to be repaid. Ulilani Philip, SABC News, Parliament.